I seem to be accumulating USB-C powered devices. So I have this small power supply. This can take power delivery in, so if we plug that in and wait for it to boot up, you'll see that it takes in 20 volts. So that's being supplied over USB-C. I also have this nice mini hot plate, which I've used for quite a few PCBs. Plug that in. And if we look at this, you can just about see there, it needs 20 volts as well. When it heats up, it will use around 50, 60 watts. So quite a power hungry device. I also have this soldering iron. We plug this in, it's another MiniWare product. Interestingly, this only takes 12.2 volts, so it's using 12 volts power delivery. I also have this other USB powered soldering iron, so let's plug that in. And if we turn this on, you'll see, I'll turn it around so you can see it, this also takes 20 volts. You can see that. So I'm suffering from a desperate need of more USB power. Currently, coming into my bench, I have one cable and that's it. So what do I need to do? I need more USB power. I'm mounting on a PCB from PCBWay. Hopefully that should come soon. It's been slightly delayed because I messed up some of the components, but we should have that soon. In the meantime, I'm going to get on with some other projects. So I've had this ATX power supply lying around for a very long time, and I've got one of these breakout boards. Look at all these lovely USB ports. So let's plug this in and see what it does. So we've only got 20 pins, so we plug it into this end. So that's attached there. We have that little green light showing that something's happening. Let's plug in our USB tester and see what we get. So we need to turn it on. Power supply starts up. It's a very noisy fan. Now the problem is, if we look at what we have on our USB tester, so let's see what we've got. Let's look at the protocols we have available. So pretty much absolutely nothing. It will do 5 volts, but that's it. So that's not particularly useful for our needs. We need USB-C. So although this power supply is great and I could build something with it, it's not really worth it. Let's turn this off because the fan's quite loud. So what's our alternatives? Let's move this massive power supply out of the way. So I looked around and I tried to find some USB-C powered hubs, but I couldn't really find any. What I did find on AliExpress though were some of these boards. So I got this board and I bought some others because I thought maybe I could use multiple of them. So these are step down converters that will output USB power delivery QC2 and QC3. So they're pretty cool. So I thought I could wire all of these up. And then looking around some more after I'd ordered these, I found this lovely board. 4 of them already wired up for me. So that's almost ideal. So what we do need is quite a beefy power supply. Our ATX supply isn't going to do it because it can't give us a high enough voltage. So what I did is I went off and I bought myself a Meanwell power supply. So this is an LRS224. So that will output 24 volts at 8.8 amps. Now, ideally, I need a bit more. We could really do with 12 amps, so we can have all 4 of these running at 20 volts, outputting 3 amps. But I decided to compromise slightly and just go for 8.8 amps input supply. So let's see what these boards are capable of. I've plugged it into my power supply, so it's getting 24 volts on the input. Let's plug in our USB tester and see what the USB-A sockets do. So there we go, we've got QC2. And we could do 20 volts. And we've got QC3, 20 volts as well. So that's pretty good. Let's have a look at what we get from the USB-C sockets. There, we'll plug into the USB-C and see what we get for that. So I plug that in. So on the USB-C, this is very cool. Power delivery 3, so 63 watts. And then we have all the other protocols you could possibly think of. So that's pretty good. So this seems like a good chance to try out the MiniWare electronic load. Let's turn it on. To turn it on, you use the set and menu buttons. And let's hook things up. So let's see how many amps we can actually get from our nice new board. So what I'll do is I'll plug our USB monitor in there so we can see what's going on, and we can trigger the different power delivery modes. And then somewhere, and we've got some cables wired up, positive, negative. There is another connector here, so you can connect through to measure the actual voltage. So when you're drawing a high current, you will get voltage drop over these wires, but we'll just use our little USB detector to monitor the voltage. So I have a very, very dodgy connection here. So we'll just plug that into there. So let's see what we get on this. So currently we have 5 volts. We're drawing 3.2 amps. Let's turn that off. So let's finish this power detection and let's enable quick charge 2. And we'll switch up to 20 volts. Should give us 20 volts. Why is it only giving us 12? So let's try that again. I've just rebooted it. Plug this in. So entering QC2. Okay, 20 volts. Perfect. So we'll pick 20 volts. And then we'll come out of this. Let's just monitor what we actually get. So we'll turn on our electronic load. Okay, so we're measuring 20 volts. Let's turn down the current to a bit more sensible. So we'll start off just drawing around 2 amps. So we'll run this. That's how the fans go. I'm drawing 2 amps here, 42 watts. So let's try bumping this up and see what we get. So that's 3 amps. We're drawing 62 watts. 3.3, 66 watts. So that's pretty good. We're drawing over 65 watts. Let's see what the actual limit is of this. Let's see when it actually fails. So up to 68 watts, and we've still got 20 volts here. That's going down a bit. So it looks like around 3.4 amps is our maximum limit on these boards. So that's pretty impressive. So we can definitely do 65 watts. So that's not bad at all. Let's turn this off. And so I'm pretty pleased with this. It does need a proper box. Obviously, I can't just have this flapping around in the breeze. I have got the nice power supply now, so I've finished my design of the enclosure for that. So that's pretty good. Looks quite nice. I'll be using this this load tester more in the future. It's very compact. The only downside is the screen is quite small, so that's a bit annoying sometimes, and quite hard to read. So if Miniware's watching, one of your display modules would be lovely. So anyway, this is a nice little project to fill in the time while I wait for my PCBs. So a bit more 3D printing to do, which is going to be fun. But I'm pretty pleased with this. Got 4 USB, USB-C power delivery, quick charge 2 and 3. So powering all my devices should be pretty easy now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.